students, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss about an assessment, that is how to write an answer when any question regarding assessment being asked. Here in today's video, I have made the sample answer for physical therapy assessment of patient suffering from osteoarthritis of knee joint. So let's get started with an answer. Before starting with assessment of osteoarthritis of knee, we'll see first the definition of osteoarthritis. So, the osteoarthritis referred to as wear and tear of degenerative joint disease, which mainly involve progressive destruction of articular cartilage that causes joint dysfunction and pain. Now let's start with an assessment. First comes the subjective assessment part. Here you have to write the name of patient, whatever is mentioned, or XYZ. Then comes the age. Most commonly affected group is more than 45 years of age. Then women are more commonly affected than men. Then regarding occupation, it mainly involves the carrying heavy weight, kneeling, squatting, and prolonged standing type of working people. They are more vulnerable to develop osteoarthritis. Then comes the chief complaint of patient. It should be written in patient's own words. You can write like pain and or stiffness in any of that, means right, left, or both knee joint while walking, stair climbing, prolonged sitting, prolonged standing, or during getting up from sitting, since either last 1 month or 6 months or any duration. Then after chief complaint comes the history part. Patient might have history of morning stiffness lasting no more than 30 minutes, severe blockage of knee joint, the history of presence of grating or clicking sound while knee joint movement or during stair climbing. After that, regarding the past history, patient may tell you about any previous meniscal or knee ligament injury, previous history of tibial plateau fracture or other fracture involving knee articular surface, or any previous history of arthritis in other joints or history of surgery on affected knee joint, for example osteotomy. Other history may include family history of osteoarthritis in any family member and the medical history of any pain medication or NSAIDs or topical diclofenac if patient is using. These were all about the possible history patient might come with. Now we'll move towards the objective assessment part, which first involves pain assessment. So here, patient with osteoarthritis may experience deep, dull aching pain around affected knee joint. The onset of pain is generally gradual. It can be sudden in case of acute one with history of jerk or twisting movement. Then, the duration of pain is commonly longer than a month. Frequency of pain is intermittent. It is more in morning and during physical activity. The pain intensity is measured using VAS, that is visual analog scale, or using NPRS, that is numerical pain rating scale. Pain intensity should be measured at rest as well as during movement. Last one in pain assessment is aggravating and relieving factors. Aggravating factors involves activities like walking, stair climbing, prolonged sitting and prolonged standing, while relieving factors involves rest after heat therapy, after medication or after physiotherapy treatment. After pain assessment, go for on observation part. The general body build is either average or obese or overweight. Here, the BMI is generally more than 25. Then, postural deformity includes malalignment of the lower limb like genu varum, genu valgum, fixed flexion deformity, altered patellar position, any pelvic positional fault, and leg length discrepancy. Here in this figure, you can see genu varum and genu valgum deformity, which is commonly seen in osteoarthritis patient. On observation part also includes presence of swelling around the knee joint. Then type of gait is commonly waddling type of gait. Then patient may walk with an assistive device like cane or walker. Then patient may wear knee brace or any kind of knee support. There is decreased stride length and there might be decreased in walking speed. Here in this figure, you can see the swollen knee joint. Now comes the palpation part. Here in osteoarthritis, temperature of knee joint tend to be warm in acute case. The tenderness is present over the knee joint line. Most commonly it is present over the medial joint line. Then crepitus, that is the coarse type of crepitations present during active knee movement. Now we'll see the examination part. The first thing in examination part is measurement of range of motion, that is ROM. Here, restricted active and passive range of motion of knee flexion and extension is there because of pain, stiffness and presence of deformity. There is empty infill in case of severe knee pain, while hard infill if any bony deformity is present. The capsular pattern of knee joint may be altered. For strength measurement, muscle grading is performed with manual muscle testing or by performing isometric resistance test. There is weakness of quadriceps and hamstring muscle in case of osteoarthritis. Hamstring tightness and iliotibial band tightness might be found in muscle length testing, and the functional limb length discrepancy may present in case of flexion deformity. Dermatome superficial and deep reflexes should be checked in case of suspected neurological involvement. Patients of osteoarthritis also need to be evaluated for altered proprioception and impaired balance. Functional assessment involves assessment of all weight-bearing activities, transfer activities, and stair climbing. It also involves assessment of home environment, including availability of Western toilet. There are so many scales or tools available for functional measurement of knee osteoarthritis. Among that, one is WOMAC, that is Western Ontario and McMaster University Osteoarthritis Index. This scale includes 5 items of pain, that means pain during walking, stair climbing, in bed activity, during sitting, lying and standing. It also includes 2 items of stiffness, that is stiffness during first walking and later on. Then 17 items of physical function, which includes sitting, stair climbing, walking, getting in and out of car, bathing, shopping, putting on and off socks, rising from bed, getting on off toilet, and heavy and light domestic duties. The total score for this scale is 96, in which 20 score for pain, 8 for stiffness and 68 for physical function. The scale indicates higher the score, higher the disability. Other functional outcomes for osteoarthritis of knee joint includes LEFS, that is lower extremity functional scale, then COOS, that is knee injury and osteoarthritis outcome score and Liquis index. Other findings involves x-ray changes. The x-ray might show narrowing of joint space, subchondral sclerosis, subchondral cyst, evidence of osteophytes, and in severe osteoarthritis, joint line may disappear completely. This x-ray picture shows all the changes of osteoarthritis of knee joint. Here is a Kellgren and Lawrence scale to grade osteoarthritis radiologically, in which the grade 1 is doubtful narrowing of joint space and possible osteophytic clipping, and grade 2 is definite osteophytes and definite narrowing of joint space. Grade 3 is moderate multiple osteophytes, definite narrowing of joint space, some sclerosis and possible deformity of bony contour is present, while in grade 4 there is a large osteophytes, marked narrowing of joint space, severe sclerosis and definite deformity of bony contour present. Then comes the ICF evaluation, that is evaluation which is based on International Classification of Functioning, Disability and Health, in which the body structure which are affected are articular cartilage and bones around the knee joint, while the function mainly affected are mobility, stability, muscle strength and endurance. Activity limitation includes walking, prolonged sitting, prolonged standing, stair climbing, transferring and toileting. Then participation includes the restriction of recreational activities, employment and community life. Then last thing is environmental and personal factors, in which the environmental factors include home adaptation, facilities like western toilet and presence of grabber in bathroom, while in personal factor there is presence of comorbidity, then lifestyle, for example sedentary lifestyle, age more than 50 years, sex, having female and social background. Fitting whole assessment, you'll have to write a possible differential diagnosis of knee joint osteoarthritis, which might be patellofemoral pain syndrome, meniscal pathology, rheumatoid arthritis, septic arthritis, collateral or cruciate ligament injury, and radiating pain from low back region. Then, analyzing whole assessment and performing special tests come to the provisional diagnosis. Problem list of patients suffering from osteoarthritis of knee joint mainly include pain, impaired knee range of motion, impaired muscle strength, impaired functional mobility, impaired balance, and impaired gait. For re-evaluation and reassessment, the standard time frame is 30 days or it is less if needed. Clinical criteria for diagnosis of osteoarthritis of knee has been established by Altman, in which the subjects with examination finding consistent with any of the three categories were considered to have knee osteoarthritis. These three categories include, the first one is the presence of knee joint and trapezius with active range of motion and morning stiffness which is less or equal to 30 minutes and age is more than 38 years. The second one is presence of knee pain and trapezius with active range of motion and presence of knee stiffness more or equal to 30 minutes and bony enlargement. Well, the last one is presence of knee pain and bony enlargement and there is no crepitus. These all are references I have referred to make this note. You can go through for detailed evaluation method. Students, if you found this video helpful, then like, share to your friends and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get my new video updates. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.